All right, now how do we change fractions and decimals into percents? Remember, percents are another type of ratio and they are always out of 100. So on a test, if we got a 90%, that means that we technically got 90 out of 100 problems correct, or 9 out of 10, or 45 out of 50. So all of those would be 90%. So how do we change a fraction to a percent? So a lot of times on your homework papers, we make it out of points, 5 out of 20 points. This would be a poor grade, we all know that. So how would we change that into what percentage we actually got? So since percents are ratios all out of 100, what we can do, the first way we can do this, is we can set up a proportion. So 5 out of 20 is equivalent to what out of 100? So we know that 20 times 5 is 100. So 5 times 5 would give us 25%. So 25% would be the answer. If we don't know how many 20s go into 100, we are always welcome to do 100 times 5 and divide it by 20 to end up getting at 25. The other way that we can do this is we can change it into a decimal and then change the decimal into a percentage. So if we take the 5 20s, we can take 5 and divide it by 20, and we would get 0.25 or 25 hundredths. And 25 hundredths then becomes 25%. Because think about it as money, 25 cents is 25 out of 100, which is 25%. So that is how to change a fraction to a percent. Now let's talk about a decimal. So in the last example, I had fractions to percents. I showed you that you can change it to a decimal and then to a percent. So let's practice this a little bit more. So if I have 45 hundredths, 0.45, all right, I can change this to a percent by moving the decimal point two places, and always two places because 100 is two tens being multiplied. So 45 hundredths would become 45%. Again, you can think about it as 45 over 100. We can change it to its fraction form. And since percents are always out of 100, it's 45%. So, what about if I don't have a two-digit number and I just have 0 and 8 hundredths? So, again, I'm going to move my decimal point two places, 1, 2, and I end up having 8%. A lot of sixth graders will just say this is 80%. So that is how I change a decimal to a percent. What about if I just had 3/10? Again, I need to move the decimal point two places. And since I don't have two places here, I can annex a zero. We learned about annexing zeros when we divided and multiplied decimals. So I can annex a zero, so I move it over once, annex a zero twice, so this would become 30%. And that is how you change a decimal to a percent and a fraction to a percent.